Well, good morning. My name is Stephen Gent. I'm an associate professor of mechanical engineering at South Dakota State University in Brookings, South Dakota. My role there is teaching the undergraduate and graduate level courses, usually in the thermal fluids engineering. Also teach a applications of CFD course, which we've been teaching for about the last 9 years and have been using STAR-CCM Plus as the primary computing tool for that. Whether it's in designing ag systems, tractors, different components of those, also medical devices and looking at the flow mechanics implications of those. And then most recently, we've been working with the Deep Underground Neutrino Experiment Project, or the DUNE Project, in the design of their long-range neutrino detector. One of the main challenges that we find in teaching, you know, a lot of the simulation tools out there is being able to have the students really readily understand and be able to pick up the technology behind the tools and to be able to tie that back into what they previously have experienced in their studies as well. Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus has been very good to work with because they have a lot of the tools and the resources that we can be able to use in the courses and be able to help enlighten the students. Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus is pretty unique in what it's offering is it provides a nice balance of the vast capabilities as well as the support, the tutorials, the Steve portal, not only from a research perspective but also from students' perspective are very intuitive and provide a lot of insight and guidance to be able to fully explore and take advantage of the capabilities of those tools. Many of the students that we have are first and second year students who may be engineers, who may be from another STEM discipline. You know, we do give them a crash course of sorts in Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus at the beginning of the summer and the beginning of the program. And then within about 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, you know, very intense training, but they're able to develop, you know, initial models and get some reasonable results with that. And they're able to, you know, gain confidence in using the tools and be able to build up their skill set and their expertise from there. The cost of performing experiments, you know, those costs are going up every year, and the industry is demanding a lot more modeling and simulation tools and students that have the expertise and experience in using modeling and simulation tools. With our curriculum, we need to be cognizant of that and really put that at the forefront to give students a really good, valuable experience in using those tools.